Alright guys, we're here doing a deck profile, deck and fight for Brawlers. It's one of my last deck and fights that I'm going to do for this season. The other deck and profile is going to be for next season when we get Fisherman Kai and I'm able to finish the Genesis deck. It's not going to be a complete deck, but it's going to be good enough to make a video, more than likely. But I still have to play test it. I really don't know anything about Genesis, so yeah. This is probably one of the easiest deck profiles or easiest decks for me to build because I've been waiting on Brawlers for so long, and it's been super fun. I've been grinding rank a lot with it. It's so strong. It literally counters Seekers as long as you know what you're doing and how you play the deck. Alright, so let's just go ahead and start with the starter. The starter is pretty good. I know a lot of people haven't been playing the starter, but I like it mostly because it has resist, but then also it has the skill that works with Big Bang. Even though Big Bang isn't your main ride that you go to, isn't the ride you go to first off when you're like grinding your opponent down, it's still good to be able to use this to hit numbers the way you need to. None of the other starters really do anything, but it's better than what this does. So what this skill is, as a forward skill like most starters do, and it has a skill when you are in Legion, count best one, put this card into your soul and then give your Vanguard the following ability. If when your opponent's front row rear guards are retired, also retire the back row rear guards. Resist do not prevent this ability. So it shuts down resist, but it doesn't shut down Garmor. So definitely keep that in mind. Just because the little protection is over it doesn't mean it's going to hit it. It just shuts down resist, so it takes out people's starters if they don't place it behind Vanguard like dummies. But it's a really good starter. It allows your rear guards to hit, to get more power for more rear guards being retired. Because Big Bang Knuckles, the one first one swinging, he's the biggest number. But then when he retires, those four units using the starter skill also, it allows your two rear guards to be able to power scale. And if you have the boosters, it definitely hits 21 and 31 if your opponent has heal triggers to check. But you know what I mean? He might be the main ride, the main focus of your deck, but he's not the main ride. He's not the first ride, I want to say. Brawler, Big Bang, Knuckle Dragon, really good Legion. Basically, the Vermillion of Brawlers. If you are in Legion, Counter Blast 2, this card gets plus 5,000 in the following ability. It swings over, when it battles the whole front row in one attack. And then it also still has the Legion skill, Vanguard skill, if when it attacks a Vanguard, plus 2k. Most Legions that have that plus 3k, if you have another card in the same column. But for some reason, all the Brawlers have the plus 2k when it attacks Vanguard. So they hit 13k base without boosters and not without Legion, I guess. And then you also Legions with Brawler, Big Bang, Slash Dragon, one of the ones that get plus 3k when a rear guard is hit by Vanguard, basically. So like I was saying, he's not your first ride, but he's definitely what the deck revolves around, especially when Big Bang Knuckle Buster comes out. He swings over four units, so it's super strong and you get super dumb power. But yeah, so your main ride, your first ride actually, is the Brawler Shotgun Blow Dragon. Now Shotgun Blow Dragon is really, really good because not only does he get rid of two rear guards, especially boosters. Boosters are pretty prevalent and important in Vanguard Zero to be able to scale numbers. And when you're continuously taking those out and then also getting a crit is super good. And if your opponent doesn't put enough gray ones in the back or enough rear guards in the back, he'll hit a front row. And if you have the starter that has resist on it, he skips the resist unit and hits the front row unit. So let's say your opponent has a starter, a grade one, and an intercept. He'll hit the grade one and the intercept, and you can swing three times at your Vanguard, plus the last swing is going to be a crit. And sometimes I win games that way because with the two retires, my rear guards are scaling. The military brawler, Lucy, and then the booster, they're scaling, so they're able to hit 21 even if your opponent hits the defensive. But what's his skill is, when Legion, Counter Blast 2, retire two rear guards, two of your opponent's rear guards at random, prioritizing the back row. If you have more units than your opponent, it gets plus crit to the end of turn. Now, you got to definitely remember that. And also remember that the Legion Mate also counts as a rear guard and a vanguard at the same time. So it counts when it comes to numbers of more units than your opponent. So, you know what I mean? Just keep that in mind when you're trying to get the crit. Just don't. Just call some rear guards down. Don't try to use your Legion first and not call any cards down. None of your units get skills if you Legion, but if you're retiring stuff off of Legion, you want to put your rear guards down anyway, especially the military brawler and the boosters. So then he also, like I said, all the brawlers have this plus 2k when it swings at that vanguard hitting 13k in base. And then also we have a really good card. It's the heal trigger. It's definitely pretty nice. It's basically a no counterblast front row retire, which is pretty strong when you want to definitely finish the games off. If you don't have knuckle bust, I mean, if you don't have Big Bang Knuckle, he's a good finisher also. With him and his Legion mate, Brawler Sky Howl Dragon, you're basically able to retire two front row rear guards for only counterblast two. So what his skill is, win Legion, retire a rear guard in your opponent's front row, and then he also has a plus 2k when he swings at a vanguard. You don't use it as much, just because that's why he's your heal trigger, but he definitely comes up. All these cards definitely comes up, and I was so glad that I was able to pull a good amount. My pulls were crazy for this set, and I only pulled, 250 or something like that? So it was super nice that I was able to get all the trippers I needed for this deck. And then, you know what I mean? The one of, y'all know the one of is player's preference. You can use whatever you want. I know honorary mention, people have been using that 10k counter charger, but I can't stand 10k grade threes because they can't hit unboosted, and sometimes you lose your boosters, or you have to use your boosters to swing at your vanguard because you don't generate a lot of card advantage. So, you know what I mean, I can't sit around and have a 10k grade three trying to swing at my opponent's vanguard. Even my grade 2s, once you use a couple skills, they hit in 12 and 15. So having the 10K is just awkward and weird. And then I want to be able to have all my grade 3s be able to be ride targets. So if I don't have my Legion, his skill is when placed on Vanguard, Soul Blast, Counterblast, to add a Brawler Skybeat Dragon from your deck to your hand. So I know Skybeat is your heal, but this is Legion, so you can put it back when you need to. But to be able to just search out a Legion mate is, I mean, a Legion is good because you want a Legion. If you're not Legioning, you're not winning because this is Legion format, so you want to make sure you're Legioning. And then he also has a skill, plus 2k when he swings at the Vanguard. So 13k, hitting them 13k numbers. Nice little SP with Skybeat. And then also, we're playing three of each Legion mate just because you don't really need. You don't really need so many of them. Now, sometimes you do run into a situation where you somehow damage check two of your legions and have one in hand, and it's a struggle, and it messes everything up and destroys your life, or one's in soul. But, you know what I mean? It's a luck of a draw when it comes to that situation, but you just want to do your best to make sure that you keep legioning back at least one of the legion mates every time you legion, just to make sure you have them in your deck when you need them. So his skill is on rear guard when your opponent's rear guard is retired during your turn. If you are in Legion, plus 3k. Remember, it's if you are in Legion. Don't be trying to get the boost when you're not having Legion yet. Make sure you don't retire anything until you Legion. And, you know what I mean, so you can get those plus powers, because those each 3k definitely matters and it comes up. And then we're also playing three of the Brawler Sky Howl Dragon. When placed, counterblast two, retire one of your opponent's front row rear guards. Like I said, with Skybeat, you basically able to take out two front row rear guards. It's really good, super strong, and then you just swing at your opponent's face. The one thing card we are playing for is the Brawler Plasma Claw Dragon. Now, Plasma Claw Dragon is basically just your counter charger. Just your Shishui. I don't know how to say his name, but the Eradicator Shishui for Brawlers. The counter charge is definitely helpful because you're playing so many Phoenixes, Rising Phoenixes, and then you also get the counter charge, so you want to make sure you don't waste these. But this is the card you really don't have to worry about putting back in your deck, because once you get going and you get towards the end, the counter charge doesn't really matter. You're just trying to get the game. But the only time the counter charge definitely matters is when your opponent is trying to, because you're playing OPG, so your opponent can damage deny you as much as possible. But if you can get that counter charge in, get that two counter blast you need back so you can use your skills and kill them, it's definitely helpful. But four is all you really need, to be honest. And then we're also playing three of the Brawler, Big Bang, Slash Dragon. When your Vanguard is Brawler, attack hits a unit, plus 3k. So, you know what I mean? When the starter triggers, it's basically hitting the Vanguard. I mean, it's basically the Vanguard hitting. So he scales in power also, not just off the retire, but just off the swing. So, really, really, really good. The deck is built to play for you to go into Big Bang Knuckle and, you know what I mean, play it that way. But, you know what I mean, all your other grade threes definitely come in handy. And with Yushui, he promotes both of them, so it doesn't really matter since you're retiring, it's basically the same. But this skill, you want to use these early, or you want to use them when you have Big Bang, because it doesn't help the deck when you're using the other legions besides him. He literally only goes with him. Besides the other ones, they can, you know what I mean, they're versatile with all the grade threes. And it's his legion, so we're doing a lot of filtering. Lightning of Hope, Helena, very important rear guard. That and the Phoenix, they're MVPs of the deck. They basically drop and draws. When you boost, you basically can drop a card from your hand and draw a card. So you're filtering, filling up your drop zone, getting everything ready for your Legion deck turn, especially when you're going second. You want to get as many cards in your deck in your drop as possible so you can Legion as quickly as possible. Like I said in other videos, this set is the only really set that you want to Legion as quickly as possible. It's your most important thing you want to do, and you know what I mean, you want to promote everything and build your deck as much as possible to hit that mark. When it comes to set 19, set 20, set 21, your strongest play is, I mean, not your strongest play, but your first play isn't going to be your Legion. You know, your Legion is probably going to be your end game or your kill turn, because a lot of those decks are still playing limit break units. So you can bide your time, play a slower game, you know what I mean, and be able to grind your opponent down before you Legion and try to finish the game. So, you know what I mean, keep in mind that the way you're playing Legion now will change when the other sets come out. And I think Genesis might be the only one that's still playing that slow game, because it's playing the break ride in the deck. So it's the limit break ride, you ride that and then you take the game slow if you're going first. But if you're going second, then you go straight to Legion and try to start promoting plays there. And we're also playing three of the Rising Phoenix. When play Soul Blast 2, draw a card. It empties your soul so you can Legion back your triggers. It allows you to draw a card. This is the only blessing that we actually have in the deck, because not only is it a booster, but it also allows you to draw a card and get cards out of your soul. So, you know what I mean? This is all we got besides taking away our opponent's resources. This is what Brawlers do. And then we're also playing four OPGs because we don't care about limit break. It does get tricky when your opponent is swinging with a crit like Risers or Genesis, so it makes it a little bit difficult because they can damage deny you very well. But you know, you have your counter charges so you can get your damage back. You don't want to get hit to five out of nowhere. Like I said, you don't need your four count. You don't need four to do any skills. No limit breaks. So you know, these are the best cards to play. Now I think Seekers was the only archetype that actually got their own PG, so that definitely realized that. And then we're also playing three of the Tanfu Brawler Arc. Now he's basically the grade one component of Yushui Lasui. He gets plus 3k when a rear guard on your opponent's side of the field is retired while you're in Legion. So you know what I mean, scaling numbers, you want to make sure you, when you use Big Bang to swing over the front row, you're hitting that 21 and 31k base, so that you, when your opponent does heal, if they do heal, you're able to definitely correct it and finish the game off. Still playing 9 draw 4 heal, super good. We was able to get our Naoki skin, even though it was like 200 VP meadow, super annoying, but you know, it is what it is. Game Studio, All right, let's get into some games and let's see how it works out. I don't have the sleeves yet for Brawlers because I haven't done any of the story yet because I'm waiting to, for the... I'm waiting for the Itachi Legion clan event. I want to get that as quickly as possible. It is four Tripwires. It should not be hard to get. My deck is ready. I'm ready to get it. So, you know what I mean? I'm going to use as much stamina as possible to be able to get the cards I need so I can play a deck and then I can have a deck profile. It's going to be super amazing. It's literally the only clan event that actually, it's the only clan that has Legion that's in the clan event that's actually good. So, you know, I want to play that. All right, you always want to put your starter to the side. You don't want to have it behind Vanguard because you want to put your Helena back there. Because if you do get Big Bang Knuckle, if he swings over the front row, and it allows you to proc Helena three times, and basically just filter out your deck until you can find which cards that you're looking for. So you want to have Helena behind the Vanguard. So you put this to the side. It's a nice booster. I'm going first, right? No, I'm going second. No. Yeah, I'm going first, so. It would have been nice to be able to have Big Bang Slash Dragon so I can hit. Never mind, that's when you want to go first. Never mind, I'm tripping. All right, we're going to put some cards down because we really want to get to our Legion since we're going second. We'll just do this. We don't have Phoenix or Helena, so I don't know how we're going to do this. Without those cards, it's extremely hard to Legion. So, to be honest, I don't think we're going to be Legion in our first turn. Even though we have our Legion that we want to do with the shotgun blow, it's going to be difficult to do that. And since he already rolled Yatriel, that means she doesn't... That's not the ideal ride for Genesis. So it's going to be a little bit tough for her also. Alright, Lang, where are you going? Phoenix, we need you. Okay. Alright. We have 2 damage, so we're fine. We can actually just ride this. No, I kind of rather put the heal back. Because we're not putting the intercepts down. So, like, it would have been nice to be able to Legion, but we didn't get any of our cards that allow us to get there. And I'm not going to neg myself just to Legion. Super not worth it when you're retiring to grade 3, and that's all, because this has resist. So, you know what I mean? It's fine. We want to keep a grade 3 in our hand anyway, because this little shardy right here has a Soul Blast 6 Glorious skill. Oh, and then she rides over. That's something. And then Legions. Instead of, she even decided to call over this to put that back. That's surprising. Alright. SP and everything. It looks so beautiful. It looks beautiful, SP, to be honest. Alright, does it have a copy of itself in the soul? Yeah, it has one. So if it Soul Blast is that to draw a card, it's going to swing with a crit. Which isn't going to be bad. It's going to be cool. Yeah, she did it. And then she's going to drop Call the Chamomile. 12k. If it has a booster, then I might be going to 5. Or I might be proccing the PG. Yeah. Then everything just goes back to the soul. Raven is so good. It's so good. It's going to be a staple in Genesis for a very long time. Oh, wow. It attacked my rear guard. Okay, I'll take that. We take that. And then this procs my PG because we're playing OPGs now. But wow, okay. I just knew I was taking some damage, but I guess she decided not to. Alright, so let's just call this out. Call this. And then call this. Hopefully, when we use the Legion skill, he hits the intercept. He usually hits it, but I talked so much junk one point and he didn't hit it. So hopefully he hits it so I can get a good amount of swings in. And I'm always gonna make sure I swing with the counter charge. But let's just see. Let's see what happens. Yes! We hit the intercept. Let's go. I love it. I love it. This hits good numbers. Everything's looking good. Alright, let's go battle. Alright, we're gonna sit here, swing, counter charge, soul charge, PG and a damage. I like to see that. Hopefully we get a Phoenix so that we can I don't have a booster, so I don't know which one to swing with. I guess I have to, because if he gets double trigger, then I'm gonna be SOL regardless. So it gets plus 2K, so hopefully I just need a trigger. Just one trigger. Yes, and it's a heal. I like it. I like it. Let's go. Let's do this. All right, two heals and the damage. We're not going to see those four. Never mind. I'm trying to. It's still two heals and the damage. We're not going to see those for a while because then she'll heal the PG. So hopefully she only has one heal to put back. That means she only has two heals to worry about. We have a grade 3 in the PG in our hand if she wants to drop Yetzirah again. So it's going pretty well. I would definitely like to see Big Bang here, but it's definitely going to be a tough situation. So does she have another copy of herself in the soul? Yeah, man, she's getting those in the soul. Oh yeah, because this card allows you to put them back in the soul. Okay. All right. Okay. Okay, so we're losing this booster here. That's fine. Not bad. And then she's gonna put us to four. Hopefully we hit some draw triggers. That's the one thing that isn't going for us right now. It's hitting draw triggers. That's the tough thing about playing against Genesis. Like, that retire is super annoying. Cause like I said, you don't get a lot of resources. So what we're gonna do here, we're just gonna re-legion, because since she put nothing in the back row, we can basically just retire intercepts. So this doesn't proc, so we're just gonna just go ahead and legion. I hope I get a grade 3, because if I don't, I may lose because of Yetzirah. I'm pretty sure she has another one somewhere. Super game ender right there. Alright. Okay, we're still good. I was just thinking, like, dang, I ain't putting enough rear guards down. No, we're getting rid of our units. She only has two to my three, so I get a crit. Alright, still gonna counter charge. I have to put intercept down. I'm gonna lose. So, yeah. So that's counter charge. Hopefully, she doesn't hit a draw trigger. No draw, but a PG, so that gives me hope that she might not have one in hand. Alright, let's hit some triggers, hopefully. Triggers? None? Okay. She has a PG, that's fine. She has six souls, so if she has Yetzirah, we lose. We just lose. It is what it is. A flag is coming. Especially, I don't think she has a copy of herself in the soul, so... That's one Yetzirah. It's two Yetzirah not in rotation, so... She doesn't have it. Okay. Okay. And we have the PG. All we really need to do is draw Big Bang Knuckle Buster. And we can get there. She has a copy of herself in the soul. So once she legions, she can just swing with a crit again. This game is definitely getting tough. Because now she's damage denying me. And I'm not checking any triggers. Like, I've been a lot of draw checks. That heal definitely saved me. I definitely appreciate that. But I really need to hit some draw triggers. I have so many in deck. Would be nice. I still have all my heal triggers back in deck. Yeah, I have no triggers anywhere but in deck, right? And then what, in soul? How many triggers in soul? Two triggers in soul. Alright. Soul charge again. Can she get that card out of her draw, out of her deck to retire? Well, she can't retire anything. Doesn't matter. Alright, she doesn't win here. But I don't know if she has the last PG in hand. She does not have the last. Well, that's, what was that? That's three PGs right there, right? So she might have the last PG in hand. Okay, okay. This card is good. This card is good. This was a nice draw. And I have enough to Legion. This was definitely a nice draw. YOLO, man. This is all I got left. If she has the last PG, then she wins. It is what it is. But, you know, if he wins me the game, that's the clutchest move ever. We're going to take care of our only intercept she has. And then we're going to swing at face. And hopefully we hit like two triggers and that can finish the game also. So let's hope for some triggers. No trigger. It's so tough. She did not have the last trigger. Okay, PG. All right, let's see if it's there. And it is not there, and we take the win. Let's go. That was the best top deck. That was the best top deck. Brawler would have been better. I'm going to keep it hot. Not Brawler, but Knuckle Buster would have been better. But that was a good top deck. That wasn't bad. I did not even think that can get me the game because of the last PG she might have had. But she didn't, so we take that win. Let's get another win in. I enjoy this coming set 21, and he will retire four units instead of just the front row. No need for the starter anymore. And we might be playing against a mirror match. All right, put this back. We're going first this time. So I guess I'll put the Sky Howl back. And get some other cards. It's definitely nice now that we don't have to worry about putting the disc behind the Vanguard. I mean the starter behind the Vanguard. Because we're going first, so that's better than what we went through last game. And then we have the Helena. So much better that we can just keep get filtering cards out. Getting through cards. We're actually playing against some kind of Eradicator Brawler stuff. Looks like. Unless they're just playing this. Because you just got to retire. You just got to ride a grade 3. It doesn't really matter. It doesn't have a preference on what you ride. Since we don't have Phoenix, I'm going to keep the counter charge and save it. Since we're going first, though. I'm going to ride that and call this because it can hit 17. I'm going to go ahead and start filtering, though. Yeah, because I need to get me a grade 3. Yep, that's fine. It's playing crits. Wow, that's something. All right, get rid of this booster. Draw Phoenix, that's good. I like that. Crits, wow. All right, so we do not have a grade 3. This is tough. This is Skip Ride. Call this. Keep swinging. Hopefully, we can filter or check some triggers. That's one. Still not a grade 3. It's fine. We couldn't Legion last turn anyway, so it's not bad. Drop this. Alright, and we got the Shotgun Blow. Yeah, I normally just draw Shotgun Blow, so dropping those Big Bang Slash Dragons doesn't really hurt because we're going to put those back in deck. We're filling the drop zone, and it doesn't really help Big Bang doesn't help Shotgun Blow to actually take games. because it doesn't get the coward scaling, but Lisui does. And then you have the counter charge, so you want to keep that. So will Phoenix next turn. Looks like he's not giving me any damage, but no need. We're not playing Limit Break, so we're just going to go ahead and get this going. All right, so we're going to Phoenix first, see what we get before we start calling cards. Soul Blast out. So we have to put back our Legion mate because we drew them all for some reason. All right, call this. Start the power scaling. Put these guys back. Put a good amount of these guys back. All right, and retire that back row because he would be annoying at some point. Since we can't take out the starter. Super weird brawler deck here. Might be some kind of budget deck though. So yeah, so we're gonna counter charge. If he doesn't hit a trigger, then we're probably swinging for lethal. And if he doesn't have a PG, then it might be game here. All right, let's get it. We have a PG. We have 2 damage. We're checking triggers. Nice. Another Phoenix. Drawing multiple Phoenixes is super nice in Legion because when you re-Legion, you always have 2 soul to be able to draw your card, and then you're putting triggers back. You're getting the triggers out of your soul and then putting them back. So super nice. All right. So bye-bye, Helena. You've been good. I appreciate you. Oh, okay. Never mind. Oh, he can't Legion. That's unfortunate. Alright. Let us. I'm going to ride this. Go ahead and search me a Legion mate. I can counter charge and then Soul Blast for a draw. Drop him. Go ahead and get that. Then we're calling this using this. Another PG, nice. Okay, so we can just keep it like this. This is fine. Like I said, we're still at 2 damage. Go ahead and counter charge. That's a good thing about him. He basically just gets me a Legion mate, so that's cool. Even though he is kind of blast Soul Blast, but it's Soul Blast, so it doesn't even matter. Alright, so we have all the components to be able to win next game, next turn. I assume that he had a PG. The reason why he didn't call enough intercepts. So this turn, he can Legion. He can take out my 2 boosters back here. And then I only have 1 intercept. Oh, he's actually going to take out the whole board. Which I guess he wouldn't because he doesn't have scaling rear guards. He has another PG. Wow. Yeah, you definitely can't play nothing but draws in this deck because this is what happens to your hand. Yeah, I think that's the PG in his hand. I'm pretty sure. Well, he's doing all that, so he's gonna take out like. He's actually taking out my whole board besides Helena, which is perfect. It's fine. Not needed. Yeah, that's all fine. We got 2 damage. We don't need to use this, so we'll just go this again. And then we'll take game if he doesn't have a heal. Call this. We're still at 3 damage, so we don't really need to call anything else. Not necessary. Next game, I definitely want to make sure I have a way to win. So put these back and put the Phoenix back. Oh, I have to put a mate back. Okay. All right, so we'll swing here. Proc his last PG. If it's not his last PG, then we can hit over a heal trigger with a crit. All right, let's go battle. PG? Yes, sir. That we knew. All right. He needs through two PGs to survive. That's one heal. I mean, he needs two heals to survive, not PGs. Which is fine, you know what I mean? We're not losing the game. And that is game. Alright, we was able to get these two wins. Super nice. Pretty amazing. Super surprised how easily that went. Even though we was playing against a weird deck and playing against Yetzriel. It's super nice. The deck performs very well. I don't really have to put any more games in, because you understand how the concept works. You know what I mean? Your game enders are Skybeat or Knuckle Buster. I mean, Big Bang Knuckle Dragon. So it's super nice. It's super fun. It definitely gets the wins that you need. It's what I've been grinding with. I haven't played Secrets yet. I'm not going to play that till next season, obviously. So here's the deck again. Everything works very well. It was able to show how good he is to be able to get to a good legion to be able to finish the game also, because he basically searches a game ender also, and when you have the legion mate in your hand, because you're taking out two intercepts. So even if he healed and dropped intercepts, I was eradicating the intercepts and just swinging for game. So pretty fun. I love this deck. I enjoy brawling with get these real fights in with brawls. My bare hands create a new world, a new future for myself. Alright. Like, comment, subscribe. All. Everything is appreciated. All support is appreciated. If you want to check me out on Twitch, it's definitely recommended. I stream on Tuesdays and Thursdays, sometimes Sundays. Hit that follow button so you can know when I'm streaming. We have lots of fun. We have great conversations about weird stuff and all kind of other stuff. But yeah, it's definitely a super great time. And you know, if you want to see more deck profiles, keep hitting that like button, the subscribe button. I have Seekers, Yetzriel or Genesis Legion and Tachi Legion coming out next season. This is, like I said, this is my last video, last deck profile this season. So yeah, I wanted to get out pretty quickly. I also have other deck profiles out there for different decks, all kind of decks that people usually don't do profiles for. If you want to check them out, check out my opinions on builds. And yeah, peace. I'm out.